It's high noon.
What's going on, everybody? It's Freedo here for Your Overwatch, and today we're going to be doing a breakdown of the skins we are likely to get, skins I would love to see, and also a bit of speculation on the upcoming event in general. First and foremost, obviously, the two main characters for this one are going to be McCree and Reaper. Last time, it was Junkenstein and his Junkenstein monster. So in general, these Halloween-themed events are continuing to go back to classic horror movie archetypes, which is going to be the recurring theme for us to speculate on what types of skins we might see for other characters. But before we get to talk about skins first, it's all but confirmed that the Junkenstein Revenge co-op PvE mission is going to be returning. Dr. Junkenstein is the poster boy symbol of the 2017 Halloween event, but also the map Eichenwald in the background is the Junkenstein's Revenge version of Eichenwald. You can tell by the platform on the back and the stairs leading up to it. That's different than how the normal map is. And of course, all the spooky effects in the background. And one step further, I think because McCree was one of the playable characters and Pumpkin Reaper was an enemy that you fought, if my memory is not failing me in this moment, I think likely the Dracula version of Reaper might be another boss or mini boss that you might fight in the mode. And what's more, I think we're likely to see Junkenstein's Revenge be upgraded slightly from what we got last year. Granted, Lucio Ball wasn't much upgraded, but it didn't need much upgrading. They made some slight tweaks and perfections to it, adding ranked and tweaking a few things, but my reasons for thinking that Junkenstein's Revenge will be even upgraded more is because the Uprising event showed the progression of their work behind the scenes on the AI. They had mentioned that it was something that they kind of had to develop and it got better over time. So if they don't add at least maybe another section to the map or more deeper gameplay elements, even if it's just more monsters, more difficulties, more stages, it might feel like a little bit of a step back from the Uprising event. And just like how Uprising had different sections with different types of bosses, we might see other classic horror movie monsters featured in the mode, in some capacity with a Overwatch-themed skin, of course. Ones that haven't really been touched yet are the Mummy, Creature from the Black Lagoon, Wolfman, although notably all of those seem a little less powerful of characters, less recognizable, than the ones that they've already used, which have thus been Frankenstein and now Van Helsing Dracula. All of the other ones kind of seem second fiddle to those two archetypes, so we might not even see any more movie types represented, but instead more Halloween-esque themes. And what I mean by that is, if we take a quick look at the skins we got last year, all the purple rarity ones are Halloween themes in terms of either being possessed or a demon. So I think it's pretty likely that we're going to get those repeated onto whatever characters are like the side characters in this event, not getting a legendary skin. But the one archetype I think they're missing is zombified characters. They should stick with the demon possessed thing. I mean, definitely May needs a possessed skin. I mean, come on, if not an entirely devil skin, a possessed one will do. But characters that are zombified would make sense. I think Genji kind of needs this one because he's kind of reanimated and brought back to life. A zombified version of the Cyber Ninja, that would be cool. But also, beyond just pure scary movie lore aspects, in my opinion, the Mercy skin isn't really her being a witch, because she doesn't look like a witch at all. She looks like a regular person in a witch costume, maybe taking her family out trick-or-treating or something, or probably out drinking, maybe. She is showing a little bit of leg after all. Not in the town, ladies. If they're gonna go that far, I think they should do all of the cosplay fans a solid and just give Mercy a nurse costume skin. Go the extra mile, Blizzard. But if not that, I'm sure there is going to be another character skin that is like a archetypical costume that people wear around Halloween, not just the scary version of characters. Perhaps the Sombra Jester skin will be good enough to fit that description. But while we're talking about comic book skins, I badly want Doomfist in that sleek white suit, but if not, Doomfist badly needs some kind of skin. He's way too cool of a character and doesn't have any yet, and I know for many players the thought of a one-hit kill around a corner is scary enough, but any kind of horrific looking theme would look cool on him. But going to the tropes of classic movies that I think that the Overwatch team might pull from, the one topping my list is that I think Widowmaker should get a Bride of Frankenstein skin. Not only does the weird hair look kind of similar to the way that Widowmaker's hair looks in-game, like it wouldn't be a stretch to make her character model look this way, it also kind of fits as well because Talon had brainwashed her, the Bride of Frankenstein's like reanimated. I don't know, it's similar. Not that it has to be, but it makes sense. To that point, it seems kind of obvious that if they're going to use Wolfman, the obvious choice is Winston. But you might argue some of his other skins already make him look Wolfman-esque anyway, so what would be the point? And there's other monster archetypes out there that are from the classic horror movie genre, King Kong, Creature from the Black Lagoon. I don't know, some of these get kind of corny, and they probably took the best archetypes that they can with Dracula, Van Helsing, and then Frankenstein and his monster before it. They haven't used many of these actually. Obviously, Reaper got the pumpkin head one, so I think it's more likely that they don't dig too deep into classic horror movie obscurity. Although I do think Orisa might look kind of cool with a Creature from the Black Lagoon skin. Some of her skins already kind of look like this, but if they were made to look more fish-like, it might fit. I've been playing a lot of Orisa lately. I'd like to get an interesting skin for her. But okay, I think that's it for the classic horror movies. I think I want to move on to a wish list of horror movies they could peek into. The problem is, the more modern these are, the more you start to step on intellectual property rights and making it so that it's probably not going to happen. But above all else, I badly want a Jason Voorhees Roadhog skin. They both have the heavy breathing, they're big scary dudes, they stalk their prey, they're slayers. I think it totally fits, and I would jump for joy to see the Jason Voorhees mask on Roadhog. I think it would look so cool. But onto other slasher movies, you could foresee a Freddy Krueger Junkrat, maybe. I know we already have Dr. Junkenstein, but I just think Junkrat fits kind of the manic crazy man vibe that Freddy Krueger has. If they want to scare all the children, they could give Zenyatta a scary clown costume. Doubt that's going to happen. More likely he's going to get like mummified maybe. That would be kind of cool. But that's it for all of my wish list. Other than that, I look forward to having another chance to get these Halloween skins. A lot of the characters that I don't have, I didn't get at the time because like I couldn't physically play Reinhardt well enough to ever use the skin, but I really want to get the Coldheart skin now, as well as any of the other ones I missed to complete my set. Another cool thing they did last year was changing the map Hollywood to be Halloween themed, as if they're shooting a horror movie there, I guess. That's really cool. It's always a lot of fun to feel like you're in the event, actually, not just with the skins wearing them, but during the gameplay, get reminded of the event going on as well. What's on your skin wish list? Are there any ones that I didn't mention, movies or archetypes from Halloween that you think definitely should be covered? Let me know in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like. It really does help us out and lets us know that you're enjoying the content. If you haven't already, please subscribe because we upload each and every day, so you're gonna want to hit the bell icon so that you get notified when our videos go live. Link to the description, you can check out our Twitter and our Destiny 2 channel. If you are a fellow Guardian, we post a ton over there, so go check it out. That's been it for me. I've been Freedo for Your Overwatch. I'll see you guys next time.